Hello and welcome. This is the earnings special on Bloomberg Quint. We are taking stock of the quarter gone by for NIIT Ltd. I'm in conversation with the joint managing director of the company and the co-founder of NIIT Ltd, Mr. P. Rajendran. Mr. Rajendran, thank you for joining us and taking the time out. Well, let me begin by asking you about how you are assessing the quarter. From what I've read in terms of the numbers, well, it looks like another steady set. What are those factors which are working out? Perhaps if you could also talk to us about the various factors that you're attributing this quarter's numbers.
Yeah, so this quarter, people who are tracking us know that the third quarter normally is a weak quarter for us. However, like you rightly said, that we have held on as a steady quarter, 227.8 crore net revenue, which is up 9% year on year. EBITDA at 20 crores, operating margin at 9%, and delivered PAT of 19.4 crores. The largest business now continues to be the corporate learning group, which has grown by 25% year on year. And it has a revenue visibility of $255 million, which has grown at 28%. Now, if you come into the details of how the quarter went in terms of acquisition of new customers, on the CLG side, the good news is we have been able to bring in two new customers. On the other side, two other customers whom we had already brought in, their revenue got a little delayed because of restructuring on their side. It was a strong quarter for the sales and sales account for CLG. We had our focus on life sciences. So just to recall, in one of the previous quarters, we had an acquisition of a company called Eagle, which was primarily focused on the health sciences area for application rollout. So what we have done is we are now starting the synergies, starting to see the synergies of the two companies, where NIIT CLG is able to work with them into their segment, which is health sciences, and get contract for development of content. And I'm sure soon enough it will be also MTS. So two such customers have got added from this relatively new sector for us, which is the health sciences. We signed totally four new contracts in quarter three, including two new MTS customers, one customer who expanded, and another customer who renewed their contract with us. So totally we have about 42 MTS customers with a revenue with a visibility of $255 million.
Sure. So so if now, I can come in on that, sir,
the part a quick of your update,
I just wanted to wanted you to elaborate a little more on the $255 million with respect to your corporate learning business. How do you think will this be spread when it comes to realization of these revenues over the, say, the next three or four quarters? How can that be, how will that show up in the books, if there is any, you know, indication that you can give us?
No, it's actually it's very tough to give that because it's not consolidated. So there will be many contracts. Let's say the Pitney Bowls contract, which we got two quarters back. There is a time which is required for contracting that, and then the transition to happen, and then the revenue starts kicking in. So different MTS contracts will be at different phases, and some of them will be getting ready for ending of the contract time when the renewal will start. So that's a tricky one. So I would not like to take that at this time.
All right. So no worries about that's accepted. But from what I understand is that the margins for a whole load of these revenues are likely to will start looking up. Is that a possibility? Does that mean that we're likely to see our EBITDA margins move into double digit anytime soon?
No, so the as far as the CLG business is concerned, the corporate learning group business, we are stable at an EBITDA of 15% now. And future, with the new orders coming in, we can only see improvement.
Okay. Mr. Rajendran, I know that this is an earnings conversation, but there's been a lot of speculation with respect to the promoter stake in NIIT Tech as well as NIIT, being on the block, and there's a lot of interest from private equities. Can you offer us any comment on this matter at this point in time?
Well, I can only say that we have also heard it like you, and it is not possible for us to comment on these matters.
Okay, so I'm assuming that because you also heard it like us, you're not in conversation with with any of the interested parties.
No comments. Okay. No comments.
Okay. All right, sir.
I told you that.
Fair enough. So in that case, I will conclude by asking you about your thoughts on how you're expecting skills and careers business to develop as we move into the next couple of quarters with respect to visibility and what you can offer us in terms of comments here.
Yeah. Right. So on the skills and career part, once again, you'll recall that about 2 years back, we completely changed and created a new product called the Stack Route. And the Stack Route was about immersive learning and probably done for the first time for corporates in India. Now, that product has got, it has matured now. We have a version which is using a proprietary virtual immersive platform. Good news is that in itself, though it is on a small base, it has grown 50% year on year. And right now we added a deep skilling initiative where a system integration company has committing about 5,000 engineers on digital technologies using our immersive platform. Also in the SNC business, last quarter, we had one of the largest banks of the country entrusting us with training of 5,000 of their 2,500 of their employees. And similarly, the TPaaS, which is the training as a service, which training pipeline as a service, which we started about 2 quarters back, that is also showing traction. One large bank has and a large IT services company have committed during the last quarter, which will spread in terms of revenues over the next 2 quarters.
Okay.
So overall, this shift into the Stack Route for highly technical people and into the TPaaS for technology as well as banking is now starting to see results.
Okay.
So, as far as SNC is concerned, it has actually grown 3% quarter on quarter. Its EBITDA has improved, and I guess we need to roll that into the over the next quarter and the next 2 years. And then, like I rightly said, the last quarter is not the best of quarters for us over the among the 4 quarters.
Okay.
And we will see a better quarter always in the quarter one of any year.
Okay. All right. Well, Mr. Rajendran, we leave it at that. Thank you so much for joining us and taking us through the quarter's numbers as well as the outlook for the company. We look forward to having a conversation with you for the next quarter as well. Thanks so much for joining in. Well, that's...